When you get a 1 kilogram spool of filament, you get 1,000 grams in a nice round strand that you can run through your printer. But you also get a spool, which is another, you know, roughly 215 grams of perfectly good plastic. So are you just gonna throw that away? These spools are often made from really good materials like polycarbonate or ABS. And I think it would be a shame to just toss them, especially because most of the plastics we chuck into the recycling bin don't actually get recycled, they get burned for energy. And what you buy as bottles made from 100% recycled material or even, you know, recycled filament, that's typically just made from remelted production scraps that have never left the factory and most likely would have been reused anyway. The most logical thing for me to do is to try and get the most out of the materials that I already have sitting around. While I'm at it, I could also try and turn some of the useless 3 millimeter filaments that I still have around into 1.75. Maybe, you know, mix in some old printed parts and finally make use of that bag of ABS pellets that I bought and only ever managed to extrude into a couple meters of filament. Of course, this is going to involve shredding and re-extruding filament. So I got in touch with 3Devo from the Netherlands and I got them to sponsor this video and to loan me one of their filament extruders, as well as their flagship plastic shredder and granulator unit. Those are quite the machines and they're too big and too heavy to use in my studio. In fact, they were delivered with a semi-truck on a pallet and that's sitting in my garage right now. So let's go check them out. The first thing that came out was the filament extruder. This is the Composer 450 and it's actually surprisingly compact. If you look at commercial filament extrusion lines, or even the extrusion line that I built a couple of years ago, those are usually at least a couple of meters long. But the 3Devo extruder routes the molten plastic and the filament around the corners, so it manages to fit the extrusion screw up top, the cooling, puller and diameter measurement unit into the side, and then around the last corner you have the entire spool winding setup. They're also including some PLA to get you started, and a bag of HDPE-based cleaning and purging material, and this will come in very useful later. The machine has you doing an onboarding process that teaches you the absolute basics, and you end up with however much of the PLA you want to turn from granulates into filament. And this turned out pretty well. I didn't clip the start of the filament into the spool well enough, so it slipped on the spool a couple of times, which means the winding isn't perfect, but yeah. That means the extruder part is ready to use. Now, the plastic shredder is a different beast. This one does require some assembly, but I totally underestimated how massive this was going to be. You can get this with just a shredder, just a granulator, or both assembled into one unit, but having both stages as a single block means there is no way I could lift this off of the pallet even with some help. So I grabbed my engine hoist, lifted it onto its base, everything gets screwed down and then the feed hopper and output container get attached. Did you notice these tabs that are sticking out of these parts? Well, those are actually safety interlock switches. Because the core shredder mechanism in this is naturally pretty dangerous when used wrong, the machine can only run when all the side covers are closed and when the hopper and outfeed container are installed, making it impossible to get your hands or any other body parts into any of the dangerous bits. And each one of these tabs is actually keyed differently, so you can't just override these by sticking a screwdriver in. I think that's a really cool detail, and it's just really refreshing to see things done correctly. Using the shredder is pretty much as straightforward as you might think. You chuck parts into the hopper and there's a little conveyor belt built into it that will automatically regulate how quickly the material is being fed into the actual shredder. You can set the RPM and all that, but I just left it at full speed, that seemed to work just fine. Now, trying to get spools in here, of course, requires some extra prep work. You'd need a ginormous shredder to grind them down in one go. What I found works best is scoring the sides and then snapping them off, which gave me 8 separate side bits and a central core to shred down. But hold on, what are we actually shredding here? Filament spools aren't all made from the same material. The most common one I had was polystyrene. Polycarbonate is also used quite a lot, and one of the older spools was polypropylene. But the ones I wanted to start with were the ABS ones. A lot of spools weren't marked at all though, so to gather a little bit more ABS, I had to start guessing. You can get a rough idea of what plastic you're dealing with by scratching and smelling it, which probably isn't super healthy, so don't try this at home, but I found three more spools that could be ABS. I cut all of those up into rough bits and chucked them into the shredder. And let me tell you, watching spools get shredded is enormously satisfying. I also shredded down the 3mm filament I had, and here the hardest part was actually getting the filament down to a size where it's going to fit into the shredder. Cutting a coil like this with a saw is nearly impossible. What I ended up doing was to unspool the entire thing, and then to cut it in half with some sharp tin snips. This was still a tangly mess to feed through the shredder, but if you don't stuff too much material in there at once, the shredder actually makes surprisingly quick work of it. I shredded down a batch of 3mm Matter Hackers and Ultimaker ABS, some dust filament PLA, and a mixed batch of polyacrylamide PLA, a couple of filament leftovers, and a bunch of printed parts thrown in for good measure.
There is a noticeable difference between the smooth, consistent feel of factory-made granules, so-called virgin material, and the less homogeneous mix of coarser particles with a bunch of finer dust that you get from shredding. But with all the shredding material ready to go, I really wanted to start turning it into filament. Because I sort of expected the shredded filaments to work pretty well, the one I wanted to start with was the shredded ABS spools. I knew that drying your input material is key for getting good extrusion results, so I grabbed a heated filament dry box and blasted the granulates for a couple of hours on the highest setting, which for this one is 70 degrees Celsius. I heated up the extruder to the ABS preset and just had a go. And here's where I started screwing up. First of all, I still had PLA in the extruder, and I purged it out straight with ABS at ABS temperatures. Not great. PLA and ABS don't mix, they don't create a copolymer, so it's really messy. And also, you cook the PLA, and the last thing you want to have is hard, charred plastic in the extrusion screw. You're supposed to use, you know, an HDPE-based material as an intermediary to purge out all the PLA at PLA temperatures, then go up to ABS temperatures and drive out the HDPE with your actual ABS. The HDPE intermediary works at both temperature ranges and doesn't degrade in the same way that the PLA sure did when I was cooking it just now. But you know what? Once all the PLA was out, I still got a nice consistent extrusion from the shredded ABS spools. So I started feeding it into the spooler, hooked it onto an empty spool, and just let it rip. And the filament I was getting looked really good actually. Diameter consistency was good, surface finish was good, so I just let it extrude and I took a break. And when I came back, I had probably around 250 grams of filament on the spool. But now, well, yeah, instead of a smooth round filament, I was getting a surface that was rough and torn up, and diameter consistency was all over the place. I was getting late, and I had a call with 3Devo the next morning anyway, so I shut off the extruder, and you know, I was just gonna ask them about it then. One of the things that 3Devo specializes in is not just designing and selling these machines, but they always also include one-on-one coaching with their materials experts. These machines really are intended for material development and prototyping, so every use case will be different and have some unique challenges that they'll work through with you. And I gotta give it to them, they were very courteous about it, but they also very clearly let me know that I screwed up here. First of all, extruding, you know, a mystery mix of ABS spools perhaps is a bad idea from the start. But also, before I turned off the extruder, I should have purged out all that mystery filament with the HDPE material. And if I was unlucky, just leaving the plastic in the hot melt zone of the extruder and shutting it off could have cooked it enough by now to cause some serious issues. That was in the manual, to be fair, but you know how good I am at reading through those. So the rest of my day was spent purging out half-burnt baby S and eventually making my way back to plain PLA and running a verification run with that, which still had some occasional blobs in there from the leftover mystery ABS, but I felt confident that whatever was still in there should come out once I'd run some higher temperature material through it. That's exactly what I did. This time though, I grabbed the Polylac 747S ABS resin that I knew had worked before in my own extruder. The first go I had with it was still a little bubbly, so I threw it back into the dryer for another 2 hours. And after that, I got a really nice, super consistent spool of tight tolerance ABS that, you know, honestly, except for the winding that isn't like super tight and neat, could totally pass as store-bought filament. The machine and the process works. It's just that perhaps my shredded ABS spools weren't really the best material to start with. But a tip that I got from the 3Devo process engineers was that I should try the polystyrene spools instead, since those were, first of all clearly labeled as polystyrene, but also they all came from the same manufacturer, Hafna. So with that, I'd have the best chance of getting a usable batch of material. I had a standard 1 kilogram spool, a small 250 gram sample spool, and a larger 2.2 kilogram one. That one I had to take to my miter saw to get into smaller chunks, but after that the shredder just tore it down into granulates, no problem. And after a bit of drying, unlike the ABS spools, the shredded polystyrene actually started extruding really well. I got a couple of tiny bubbles in there, so the second refill I dried a bit longer, but yeah, this extruded much better than the ABS spools. I also made these two spools. This one is shredded PLA filaments and printed parts just mixed together. It's this stuff right here. And I was really surprised by how well the different colors ended up mixing together, making this really beautiful chalky lavender color. And the other one is the ABS spools, but instead of doing just the recycled material, I used a special recipe of 2 cups ground spools, 2 cups Polylac ABS, all baked at 70 degrees Celsius for 2 hours, and out came this perfectly fine spool of not quite black ABS, and it had none of the surface tearing issues that I got with only extruding the shredded spools. So, how do these print? Let's go find out. I printed these little low-profile clamps designed by Taylor's Make, and as a printer I used the XL because it has jam detection and 5 tool heads. If I clog one because my filament had some junk in it, I can just leave it, worry about it later, and move on to the next one. Let's start with what didn't work, and that's both the pure ABS and the polystyrene spool filament. One thing that I realized after the fact with all of the materials is that I should have dried them more. So occasionally I got these little steam pockets in the filament that would be too big to fit through the extruder, and the XL would send me a notification and be like, a little help here please. But on top of that, I think the polystyrene spool material, I didn't clean off the labels well enough, and that ended up creating an unmeltable residue that would clog the nozzle. The thing is, more aggressive solvents that would clean off the labels are hard to use with that styrene material because they also start dissolving the spool itself, so you end up mixing it all together. But even for the bit that did print, the material looks brittle and dry, for lack of a better word. It might just be that these spools were already made from a recycled low-grade material, because honestly, for a spool, it just really doesn't matter all that much. On the other hand, the filament made from the ABS spools did look a bit better. I used the start of the filament where it had still extruded smooth, and that managed to print this much until the filament got snagged. Not the best result, but the material itself seems a lot more promising, and with a little more drying it could totally be usable. But the 50-50 mix of virgin ABS and recycled spools is where things really started coming together. This stuff was much more consistent to extrude and printed really well. I think adding this much fresh material is a good sweet spot to still make use of a considerable amount of old shredded plastic,
but then push the material properties towards an area where you know it's actually going to be usable material too. And what should be absolutely no surprise at this point is that the filaments made from 100% virgin material, ABS and PLA, also printed perfectly. These are just every bit as good as store-bought material. The mixed PLA batch also worked, but one tip I got from 3DEVO was that if you're starting from different kinds of input materials, in this case shredding both old filament and 3D prints, it's a good idea to run the shredded material through the shredder again to get a more consistent particle size and, as a result, a more uniform extrusion. Now, if you're wondering about whatever happened to the Ultimaker and Matterhackers PLA filament that are shredded, I think I managed to contaminate it with just the tiniest amount of particles from the shredded ABS spools, and that messed up the extrusion consistency. Any amount of ABS contamination just came out as a solid chunk, and I really should have cleaned out the shredder more thoroughly when I was done with the ABS spools. I think that experience also does a great job explaining why you so rarely see commercial recycling happening of actual, you know, 3D printed parts that are getting reused. If you collect, say, PLA from a bunch of different people and there's just a single ABS part mixed in, congratulations, you've just ruined an entire batch of shredded material. The recycling companies that do exist get around this by mostly relying on perfectly clean industrial waste, like sprues from injection molding, and by B, grinding down anything that's being sent in into a really fine powder, a lot finer than this stuff, so that if there is any kind of contamination there, it's just going to be a speck of dust and pass right through your printer's nozzle. But grinding it down so much also degrades the polymer itself, so that's not great either. So I feel like I've got a decent grasp of how to use these machines now. The question is, what do you want to see me use them for? Let me know in the comments, and if we get a crazy enough suggestion there, I might be able to hang on to the 3DEVO machines for a little bit longer before I have to send them back. We can do compound plastics, additives, fibers, glitter, you name it. Anything that fits through a 3D printer nozzle without ruining it is fair game. And if you want to see the 3DEVO machines in person, you can do so at Formnext. They'll have their next generation extruder with them, the Filament Maker 2, that has a new screw design, new UI, a more capable diameter sensing system, and lots more. And if you're working in a project that involves recycling plastics for 3D printing, or even creating a brand new material that you can't just buy as filament off the shelf, get in touch with them and talk to one of their materials experts at the link in the description about how you can put these machines to use in a free 2-month trial. Thanks for watching, keep on making, and I'll see you in the next one.